Nature astounds and inspires us with its diversity of oceans and wetlands, forests and grasslands. These special places play a vital role in the production of the planet's oxygen and rainfall. They also produce a rich abundance of fish, wildlife, and plant species that sustain our lives and nurture our spirits. Our nation's culture, health, and economic well-being are tied to this interconnected web of life. But accelerated global climate change is changing the natural world as we know it. The U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service conserves our nation's heritage of wild things and wild places. This task is made more difficult by challenges such as habitat destruction and fragmentation, invasive species, and water scarcity. Now, worldwide scientific consensus tells us that human activity is changing the climate system itself. As climate changes, the abundance and distribution of wildlife and fish will also change. Some species will adapt successfully to an abruptly warming world, many will struggle, and others will disappear. Endangered and threatened species now living at the limits of survival are vulnerable, as are those living within confined geographic ranges with limited abilities to move rapidly in response to changing climate. Barriers to migration, increased competition for habitat, and the lack of suitable or available food could make things difficult for species moving to new locations.
In the Florida Keys, we have more than 20 federally listed threatened and endangered species, from the Shouse swallowtail butterfly up to the more well-known key deer. And all of these species are, for the most part, restricted to being here in the Florida Keys. So as we lose habitat, we may literally lose species that are found nowhere else.
In addition to terrestrial species, aquatic resources are declining at alarming rates due to habitat loss, contaminants, invasive species, overexploitation, and most recently, diseases, stresses that are exacerbated by climate change. Increasing human population will intensify the competing needs of cities, agricultural areas, and wildlife. In a changing climate, effective management of vital natural resources such as clean water will be of even greater importance in sustaining habitats that support plants, animals, and people.
Our freshwater species are disproportionately imperiled as compared to other plants and animal species in the U.S. Of about 800 native freshwater fish species, 37% are in need of conservation action. 70% of our freshwater mussel species are seriously imperiled, and many are already listed as threatened or endangered. Climate change is likely to impact fish habitats. As fish habitats decline, so do the numerous values they provide for natural resources, human health, and a sound economy. Recreational fisheries help generate hundreds of millions of dollars in local economies throughout this country. If climate change diminishes the quality and quantity of our aquatic habitats, that will have a profound impact on these special places and the people and wildlife that depend on them.
As the nation's principal federal conservation agency, the U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service is dedicated to helping species adapt to a rapidly warming climate. Our 8,000 employees specialize in wildlife management and ecosystem dynamics and have an extensive network of partners. Dealing with climate change is not a solitary endeavor. Close collaboration with partners is critical. It requires a landscape conservation approach, emphasizing large areas with interconnected and ecologically functional habitats capable of sustaining many species.
The service and the public are going to help plants and animals move across the landscape to keep pace with climate change. In many cases, this means establishing or maintaining a corridor of habitat across the landscape in the direction that the plants and animals are going to be moving in order for them to have a place to go. In many cases, we've actually severed these connections with roads, development, which these plants and animals can't cross. So where these corridors still exist and are intact, we want to try to maintain them. And where they've been severed, we want to try to reconnect them.
One expected effect of climate change is sea level rise. At Blackwater National Wildlife Refuge in Maryland, resource managers are monitoring climate change impacts using a special climate model that measures the effects of sea level rise on marshes.
The loss of 8,000 acres of brackish marsh habitat has a significant impact on what's going on out here. These marshes are important to more than just wildlife. These marshes are critical to not only the local economy, because these marshes support the local fin and shellfish industries. They're important to the health of the bay. They also provide wildlife viewing opportunities for ecotourism, as well as help to buffer storm effects to the local community. We will continue to lose marsh habitat as a result of sea level rise as well. The model will help us to identify those places where we'll be able to maintain marshes in the long run and help plan future management activities.
Climate modeling is also being used in the Florida Keys National Wildlife Refuge Complex.
Our highest priorities right now for assessing and adapting to the impacts of climate change would be to take some of the large and complicated scientific models that tend to be global and regional in scale and bring them down to the local level so that we can better predict what the impacts might be, the time frame in which we can expect those impacts, and what types of strategies we should implement in order to prepare for the changes that we might see.
The impacts of climate change reach far beyond coastal areas, from melting sea ice in the Arctic to water scarcity in the Southwest. In the upper Midwest, thousands of shallow wetlands known as prairie potholes are remnants of retreating glaciers from the last major ice age. Thousands of waterfowl and other grassland birds rely upon these lands and waters to continue self-sustaining populations. And thousands of duck hunters and communities rely upon the seasonal activity of waterfowl hunting. As the climate warms, farmers in the region will be able to plant crops farther north, converting native prairie and wetlands to agricultural fields. The conversion of virgin prairie where cattle graze to planting of row crops will mean more carbon in the atmosphere and loss of wetlands for waterfowl breeding.
If we see a continued conversion of the grassland, loss of the wetlands, there's going to be a reduction in the migratory bird production on a North American continent. And that's going to have a huge impact on those that are interested in hunting, those that are interested in bird watching. There's a tremendous industry associated with tourism and visitation to refuges and other wildlife areas. And the interest, obviously, is going to go down if there isn't the production there, if there isn't the number of birds there that people are going to be able to enjoy.
If we're going to be successful in conserving the nature of America, then we simply have to understand the causes and the effects of a changing climate system and what that means for fish and wildlife populations. The service has a good beginning with our draft strategic and action plan. But we need to recognize that we can't address something as large and encompassing as climate change from within the footprint of our own organization. We are really dependent on building relationships with partners. We need to look for new ways to speak to the public and inform the public about what we're doing and why responding to changing climate is an important aspect of wildlife conservation.
America has faced adversity in the past, from the severe droughts of the 1930s to the environmental effects of chemical pesticides to the ongoing challenges of recovering threatened and endangered species. The warming of the earth could potentially have more far-reaching impacts on wildlife and wildlife habitat than any challenge that has come before. Together with our partners, we will face the challenges of our time and change the future for the better.
Our mission is not only protecting the wildlife and their habitats for present generations, but for future generations. It would be easy for me to put on the blinders and think, I'll be here for the next 5 or 10 years and that's what I'm going to focus on. But it's difficult for me to do that when I read about climate change and I have concerns about these species and what kind of a legacy can we leave for, you know, our children and our grandchildren. And so I think it's really important for us to be addressing these issues. Thank you.